Can you solve this geometry challenge? Here's the question. Solve for the value of h, given this figure. So here's this h. This angle measures 30 degrees. This angle measures 60 degrees. And the total length of this base must be equal to 100 units. Now, you can pause this video if you want to give this problem a try. Now, suppose you pause this video. Now, let's see if you get the correct answer. Now, to answer this question, I prefer three different methods to solve for the value of h. Now, here's the possible methods. The first one is by using trigonometry. The second one is by using special right triangle, especially 30-60-90 right triangle. And the third one, my favorite, is mental calculation, of course, through the use of special right triangle. Now, let's have our first solution using trigonometry. Alright, so to answer this using trigonometry, let this base right over here be equal to x. Now, since the total length is 100, the other length must be equal to 100 minus x. Now, let's use tangent function. In this right triangle, we can say that tangent 60 degrees must be equal to h over x, or simply the opposite side over the adjacent side. So we have tangent 60 degrees equals h over x. Now, in this big right triangle, using again tangent function, we can say that tangent 30 degrees must be equal to the opposite side, which is h, over the adjacent side, which is 100 minus x. Now, let's simplify first the first equation that comes from the small right triangle. Alright, now we know tangent 60 degrees must be equal to square root of 3. Now, let's solve for the value of x in terms of h. So, how to do that? First, let's cross multiply. So, we have x multiplied by square root of 3 equals h, and then divide both sides by square root of 3. Now, x equals h over square root of 3. So, we will use this value later on. Now, how about tangent 30 degrees? We know tangent 30 degrees is a special angle. This is equivalent to square root of 3 over 3. Now, let's multiply both sides by 100 minus x to solve for the value of h. And then, what we're going to do here is to replace this x with this value, h over square root of 3, because in this question, we want the value of h and not the value of x. Alright, so let's replace this x with h over square root of 3. Now, at this point, let's distribute the square root of 3 over 3 to 100 and h over square root of 3. If we do that, we get this square root of 3 over 3 times 100 minus square root of 3 over 3 multiplied by h over square root of 3 equals h. And if we multiply this 2, we get 100 multiplied by square root of 3 over 3. And if we multiply these two terms, take note that we can cancel out the square root of 3 on the numerator and denominator. So this is just negative h over 3. Now, let's multiply both sides by 3. If we do that, we get 100 square root of 3 minus h equals 3h. And then, let's add h on both sides. And if we do that, we get 100 times square root of 3 equals 4h. And we want h, so divide both sides by 4. And sure enough, we get 100 over 4, or simply equal to 25, multiplied by square root of 3. And that is the value of h using trigonometry. Alright, so we now know the answer, which is the value of h is h equals 25 times square root of 3. Now, how about our second solution, which is using special right triangle? So, in this case, we will use special right triangle 30-60-90. Alright, now, to start using this method, take note that this angle right here must be equal to 30 degrees because the sum of the angles inside a right triangle must be adds up to 180 degrees. So we have 60 degrees plus 90 degrees plus 30 degrees. This will adds up to 180 degrees. Also, if this is 30 degrees, this is 90 degrees. So this angle right over here must be equal to 60 degrees. All right. Now, using this concept, of 30, 60, 90 right triangle, the ratio of each side must be equal to a is to 2a is to a times square root of 3. So if the smaller leg, this a, the smaller leg is the opposite of 30 degrees. If this is a, the hypotenuse is twice of it, or simply equal to 2a, and the longer leg, or the opposite side of 60 degrees, must be equal to a multiplied by square root of 3. So using this concept, we can now answer this question, or we can now find the value of h. So using this, from this one, this is the shorter leg because this is the opposite side of 30 degrees. So if this is h, the longer leg must be equal to h multiplied by square root of 3. All right. And then, in this case, the opposite side of 60 degrees must be equal to h. So the shorter leg must be equal to h over square root of 3. So if we multiply this by square root of 3, we get the longer leg, which is h. All right. Now from here, take note that the total length of this base must be equal to 100. So if we add h over square root of 3 and h times square root of 3, we end up with 100. Or simply, if we go to an equation, we have h over square root of 3 plus h times square root of 3 must be equal to 100. Now using this equation, we can now solve for the value of h. So to do that, let's multiply all of this term by square root of 3. And if we do that, we get h plus h times square root of 3 times square root of 3 equals 100 times square root of 3. And if we multiply this, square root of 3 times square root of 3, this is just square root of 9, and this is just 3. So we have h plus 3h, and h plus 3h, we all know that. This is just 4h. And here we go, we want the value of this h, so divide both sides by 4. Then 100 square root of 3 divided by 4, this will give us 25 square root of 3. So still, the value of h using our first method trigonometry is the same thing, of course. We have 25 times square root of 3 units. So using the second method, we get the same thing. Now, how about the third method, which is mental calculation? But again, through the use of this 30-60-90 right triangle. So to answer this using mental calculation, imagine that this is a whole rectangle. And imagine also, since it is a rectangle, this angle must be equal to 90 degrees. So this angle must be equal to 30 degrees. The other angle is 60 degrees because we have here a 90 degrees. And also, since it is a rectangle, the opposite side are equal, so the length of this white segment must be equal to 100 units also. Now from here, we will apply the 30-60-90 right triangle ratio. So the hypotenuse is 100, therefore the side opposite of 30 degrees, or the shorter leg, must be half of it, or simply 100 divided by 2, or simply equal to 50 units. And since we know the shorter leg, so the longer leg must be equal to 50, the shorter leg, multiplied by square root of 3, or simply 50 times square root of 3. Now, this is now the hypotenuse of this right triangle. So this is the hypotenuse, and this is the shorter leg, which is h. And we know this is just half the hypotenuse. So 50 times square root of 3 divided by 2, this will give us 25 times square root of 3. And that is the value of h. Therefore, given this figure and using these three different methods, we can say that the value of h must be equal to 25 times square root of 3 units. And as always, we are done.